Hello, welcome to Evan Singh Academy. This is another session of coordinate geometry, and I am here with you, myself Evan Kumar Singh, and we are going to discuss coordinate geometry today. We have already discussed about the distance formula, the Cartesian system. I hope you have learned those distance formula. Now let me discuss some application of those distance formula. What will be the application of all distance formula? And thereafter we will discuss some more questions as well and some more concepts. So let me discuss about the sum application of distance formula. For this, I just recall you that distance formula is what? Distance between two points P and Q, whose coordinates are x1, y1 and x2, y2, is given by x2 minus x1 whole square minus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the formula which we have learned. Now, what to do? We have to apply this to find the different length that can be in a square, that can be in a rectangle, that can be in isosceles triangle, that can be right angle triangle. So we can have some questions by using this. So let me discuss few questions. Question number one I am taking here. Prove that, question would be like this. Prove that the points 5, 6, 5, 6, 1, 5, 1, 5, and 2, 1, and 6, 2 are the vertices of a square. Vertices of a square. This we have to prove. This is the question. Prove that these are the vertices of a square. So we can write it. Let A, B, C, D are 4 points. First point can be described as 5, 6, B is 1, 5, C is 2, 1, and D is 6, 2. This is not as per Cartesian system, every little this point, no need to mark it on Cartesian system or x-axis and y-axis with reference to x-axis and y-axis. You can just mark this, and now we can find the value of AB, BC, CD and BN. If all four sides are equal, then we can say this is a what? Rhombus or a square? If all four sides are equal, then we can say it is a rhombus. To prove a square, we have to also prove the length of diagonals are also equal. So we will find the six distance we have to calculate. First, let me find AB is equal to what? AB is x2 minus x1 whole square, 5 minus 1 whole square, 6 minus 5 whole square, and what is that? 5 minus 1, 4, 4 square is 16, plus 1 square is 1, so that is under root 17. Now, if I would consider BC, then what will happen? This is under root 2 minus 1 whole square, 2 minus 1 whole square, plus 1 minus 5 whole square, and that will be also root 17. If I would consider this, CD is what? So CD will be 6 minus 2 whole square, 6 minus 2 is 4, and 2 minus 1 is 1, so 4 square, that is 16, 1 square plus 1, so this is also root 17. And BA, that can be also calculated by using this, that 6 minus 5 whole square, 6 minus 5 whole square, plus 2 minus 6 whole square, that will also come up like 1 square, 6 minus 5 is 1, 1 square is 1, and 2 minus 6 is minus 4, minus 4 whole square is 16. So that is also 17. So length of all four sides are equal. If length of all four sides of a quadrilateral are equal, then it is a rhombus, not the square. To prove it a square, the length of diagonals are also equal, that you have to prove. So here, AC can be calculated in the similar fashion. AC is what? 5 minus 2 whole square, right? Plus 6 minus 1 whole square. 6 minus 1 whole square. So 5 minus 2, 3. 3 square is 9 and 5 square is 25. So that is under root 34. Under root 34. AC is this, and BD is also, BD can be calculated by using the same fact. That 6 minus 1 whole square, 6 minus 1 whole square, plus 2 minus 5 whole square, and that will be also root So here we can say that since AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DA, and moreover AC is equal to BD, and therefore ABCD is a square. That is the proof of this. Right now? So in school examination, if you have any such questions, then you have to prove all four sides are equal. And apart from proving all four sides are equal, you have to also prove diagonals are of equal length. Then only it will be square. This is the basic difference between rhombus and square. All a square is a rhombus, but all rhombus not necessarily a square. Remember that. So here the specific case of rhombus is a square. And what is that specific case? That length of diagonals are equal. Now let me write the next question. Question is, prove that P 2 minus 2, Q 14 comma 10, R 11 comma 13, and S minus 1 comma 1 are the vertices of a rectangle. That you have to prove. Are the vertices of a rectangle. So let me prove this solution. What to do? We can construct a rectangle ABC PQRS. P is this 2 comma minus 2. Q is 14 comma 10. And R is 11 comma 13. And S is what? Minus 1 comma 1. Now we can find the length of PQ, and length of PQ can be calculated by using this fact that distance formula. PQ is what? PQ is under root h2 minus h1 whole square, 14 minus 2, that is 12 square, plus 10 minus minus 2, that will be 10 plus 2, again 12 square. 12 square plus 12 square is 2 root 12 square, 2 into 12 square, so which will come outside, and it will be 12 root 2, right? 12 will come outside and 2 will remain inside. Got it? Okay. So PQ is this. Now we can calculate SR. SR is what? 11 minus minus 1. 11 minus minus 1, that is 11 plus 1 whole square, plus 13 minus 1, that is 12 whole square. So that is also coming here, 12 square plus 12 square. This will be also 12 square plus 12 square. So that is 2 into 12 square, which will come outside 12 root 2. So opposite sides are equal. Here PQ is equal to ASR. Opposite sides are equal. Also, PS is equal to, what is PS? So PS can be calculated 2 minus minus 1, that is 2 plus 1 whole square, plus minus 2 minus 1 whole square, that is 3 square plus minus 3 square. What will be that? 2 into 3 square, that is 3 into root 2. That is 3 square 9 plus 9, 18, and square root of 18 is 3 root 2. So PS is like this. QR is what? QR, that can be also calculated like 14 minus 11 whole square, right? Plus 10 minus 13 whole square. So again, this is nothing else but 3 square plus minus root 3 square. That will also come the same thing. So 3 root 2. And therefore, PS is equal to QR. This is the second relation. Can you say the opposite sides are equal, then it is a rectangle? No, we cannot say. Opposite sides are equal in parallelogram as well. So to be specific about the rectangle, you need to prove the length of diagonals are also equal. So here also, PR is equal to, what is this? PR is equal to 11 minus 2 whole square, 11 minus 2, that is 9 whole square, plus 13 minus minus 2, that is 15 whole square. So this is 81 plus 225, right? 81 plus 225 is equal to 5 plus 1, 6. 8 plus 2, 10, and this is 2 plus 1, 3, 306. Also, QS is equal to, in the similar pattern, what will come? 14 minus minus 1, that is 14 plus 1 whole square, and 10 minus 1 whole square, 10 minus 1 is also 9, 9 square is 81, 15 square is 81, 225 plus 81, and that will be also what? Under root 306. So, PS is equal to QS. This is the third relation, and therefore from first, second and third, we can say PQR is a rectangle. From first, second and third, we can say that PS is equal to PQR is a rectangle. Why? Because opposite sides are of equal length, and what is more about? Opposite sides are of equal length and diagonals are also equal. So this is the basic difference between parallelogram and rectangle. Here, opposite sides are equal since PQ is equal to SR and PS is equal to QR and diagonal PS is equal to PS, PR is equal to QS, PR, sorry, this is PR is equal to QS, PR is equal to QS, and therefore PQRS is a rectangle, PQRS is a rectangle. So this is the question. I hope you got it, right? Length of opposite sides are equal and diagonals are of equal length. If that is proved, it means it is a vertices of rectangle. I hope you got it, right now? So, let me discuss some more questions. Third question I am writing here. This is question number 3. What is that? Prove that L00, M55 and M-55 are the vertices of an isosceles right angle isosceles triangle. Right angle isosceles triangle. Right angle isosceles triangle. Prove that L, M, N are the vertices of right angle isosceles triangle. So what is that? First, let me write solution. Here, this is, say, vertices P11. We can write this, we don't know which one is right angle. So let me calculate first LM using the distance formula. What is LM or LM square? If I would write LM square, then no need to write a square root. So LM square is what? 5 minus 0 whole square plus 5 minus 0 whole square. That is 5 square 25 plus 5 square 25. What is that? 50. Right? Similarly, MN square is what? MN square is 5 minus minus 5, that is 5 plus 5 whole square, and 5 minus 5 whole square, that is 0 square. So 10 square is 100. 100 plus 0 is 100, this is second one. And LN square is equal to, what is that? 0 minus minus 5 whole square, 0 minus minus 5, that is 0 plus 5, plus 0 minus 5 whole square, 0 minus 5 whole square. Again, this is 25, this will be also 25, because the square of negative sign will be always positive. So 25 plus 25 would be 50. Now, from this, we can say, since ln square is equal to ln square, both of them are equal, and therefore we can say LM is equal to LN, and therefore triangle is what? Two sides are equal isosceles, celes, and two sides are equal, therefore isosceles. Also, we can write here LM square plus LN square is equal to MN square. Sum of a square of two sides are equal because 50 plus 50 is 100, and therefore it is right angle triangle. This is implies it LMN is right angle triangle. Right angle triangle. Right? So two properties came. One is isosceles, another is right angle triangle, and therefore we can say finally LMN is right angle triangle. Right angle isosceles triangle, isosceles triangle, right angle isosceles triangle. I hope you got it right now. So distance formula has to be used to find those lessons, and if you know the distance formula, you can apply it to solve any questions related to this. So third question is over. Now let me write another question. There is a question: for what value of k 0 to is equidistant from points 0 to 2 equidistant from points A 3k and B k 5. This point is considered as P. P is equidistant from these two points, that is the question. For what value of K, we have to calculate that this P is equidistant from A and B. Since P is equidistant, that is the distance of P from A and distance of P from B are equal, so in solution, we can proceed from PA is equal to PB. This is the given equidistance. This implies PA whole square is equal to PB whole square. Right? Now, PA square is equal to, using distance formula, I can write again 0 minus 3 whole square plus 2 minus K whole square is equal to PB. PB is what? 0 minus k whole square. No need to write a square root because I have written already a square here. Remember this fact. And 0 minus k whole square plus 2 minus 5 whole square. 2 minus 5 whole square. Now 3 square is 9. This is 4 minus 4k plus k square. Here also this is k square and this is 2 minus 5 minus 3. Minus 3 whole square is 9. So we can cancel k square, we can also cancel 9, and then what is left? 4 is equal to 4k, because this 4k will come this side, it will be positive, and therefore k is equal to 1. So value of k is 1. This will be the answer. Answer. Equidistance means equal distance. And equal distance from what? Equal distance from point P, 0, 2, and where, from whom it is equal distance? From A and from B. So PA is equal to PB. And therefore PA square is also equal to PB square. Like that. I hope you got it. Okay, if you are not able to get it, let me solve one more question of this category, and then definitely you will be able to understand it. Find the coordinate of a point, slightly different. Find the coordinate of a point, which is equidistant, from 1 to 3, comma, minus 4, and 5 comma minus 6. Let these are the three points, and we have to find a point which is equidistant. Let O be, let O, this is a point O, say O is a point, and this is equidistant, this point is O, and this is equidistant from these three vertices A, B, and somewhere maybe C. These are the three points. So OA is equal to OB is equal to OC. Say A is equal to 1 comma 2, B is equal to 3 comma minus 4, and C is equal to 5 comma minus 6. And OB any point, say X comma Y, which is equal distance from all these three points. So we can write solution like, let O X Y be any point which is equidistant from A 1 comma 2, B 3 comma minus 4, and C 5 comma minus 6, and therefore OA is equal to OB is equal to OC. OA is equal to OB is equal to OC. All three of them are equal. OA is equal to OB is equal to OC. We can start from OA is equal to OB. We can start anything. OA is equal to OB, which will give OA square is equal to OB square. OA square is equal to OB square, right? This further gives OA square, that is X minus 1 whole square plus Y minus 2 whole square. And OB square is X minus 3 whole square plus Y plus 4 whole square. Like that. Now what will happen? X square minus 2X plus 1, or intelligently one can write it. Similar, x square will come from this side, x square will come from this side, so that will vanish. Y square come from this side, and y square will also come from this side, so that will also vanish. What is left here? Minus 2x plus 1. What is left here? Minus 4y plus 4. What is left here? Minus 6x plus 9. And what is left here? 4 to 8y plus 16. That will left. Agree or not? If you are not agree, then I can rewrite again the whole equation, and thereafter I can cancel the only these two things will left. So I can write here, if I explain this, minus 2x plus 1 plus y square minus 4y plus 4 is equal to x square minus 6x plus 9 plus y square plus 8y plus 16, and now you can cancel x square and y square, same thing will left, nothing different. So 6x will come this side and it will be positive. So when 6x will come this side, 6x minus 2x, that is 4x, minus 4y this side, if 8y will come hit this side, this will be also negative. So minus 4y plus 8y minus 4y minus 8y will be minus 12y. 4 plus 1 is 5, and 16 plus 9 is 25. So 25 minus 5 will be 20 only. And now if I cancel this by 4, this is x minus 3y is equal to 5. This is the first equation. Also, we can proceed from OB is equal to OC. This employee OB square is equal to OC square, and which will further give OB square is 3 minus x minus 3 whole square plus y plus 4 whole square is equal to OC will be x minus 5 whole square and x y minus minus 6, that is y plus 6 whole square. If again I can write this in the similar pattern, x square minus 6x plus 9 plus y square plus 8y plus 16 is equal to x square minus 10x plus 25 plus y square plus 12y plus 36 will come x square y square, x square y square will cancel out. And what is left here? 10x minus 10x will come this side, it will remain 4x. And 12y will come this side, it will remain minus 4y, because 8y minus 12y will be minus 4y. 16 plus 9, 25, and 25 cancel. So what is left? 36. Or x minus y is equal to 9 if I divide by 4. So from first and second, we can solve them. What will be that? Let me write this. From first and second, two equations came here. From first and second, what will come? X minus 3y is equal to 5 and x minus y is equal to 9. So these are the two equations. If I can subtract this, right? So sign will change, x cancel, minus 2y is equal to minus 4, so y is equal to 2, and if I can put value of y anywhere, then y is 2, it means what? X minus 2 is equal to 9, so x is equal to 11, and therefore required point is 11, 2. And that will be answer of this question. So I hope you got it, right? Let me explain this. Some other question, I hope you got it. Equidistance from three points, that has been written here, and that is basically lie at the center of the circle. Three points lie on circumference, and this point lie on the center of the circle. But in the limited idea, if you go in class 12, then we will have a separate idea to solve this questions very quickly. But still, when you are in class 10th only, then in that case, this is a limited idea in which you can solve. Because we can use only distance formula, no other formula can be used, and therefore limited options are left to solve the question. Now, considering one more question, what is that? Let me explain. Question 6. Find the value of P for which minus 1 P, 2 P and 5 minus 1 are collinear. Yesterday I had discussed the concept of collinearity, and I hope you remember this. Collinearity is what? Collinearity is something sum of 2 is equal to 3. That is, if A, B, C are 3 points, then we can have collinearity like, if A, B, C are 3 points, they lie on the same line, then there must exist a relation, that is AB plus BC is equal to AC. If this relation will exist, then points are collinear. So let me solve this. Let A minus 1, 3, B 2, comma P and C 5, comma minus 1 are 3 points. 3 points. 5, comma minus 1 are 3 points. Now AB, distance AB is equal to what? AB is minus 1 minus 2 whole square plus 3 minus P whole square, right? And BC is what? BC is 2 minus 5 whole square plus P plus 1 whole square. That is AB and BC can be calculated, which is further can be calculated like minus 3 whole square is 9 plus 9 minus 6 P plus P square. That will come, or finally it is 18 minus 6 P plus P square. Here BC will also come like what? 2 minus minus 3, that is minus 3. Minus 3 whole square is 9 plus P square plus 2 P plus 1. So it will come like P square plus 2 P plus 10. And now AC is what? AC can be calculated like the same question. 5 minus minus 1, that is 6 square plus minus 1 minus 3 whole square, that is 4 square. So it would be 6 square 36 and minus 4 whole square is 16. So 36 plus 16 is root 52. That is 2 root 13. That can be calculated. Now